Forever could never be long enough for me. Feel like I've had long enough with you. Forget the world now, we won't let them see. But there's one thing left to do. Now that the weight has lifted, love has surely shifted my way. Marry me today and every day. Marry me. If I ever get the nerve to say hello in this cafe, say you will. Say you will. Together could never be close enough for me to feel like I am close enough to you. You wear white and I wear out the words I love you and your beauty. That the wait is over, love has finally showed her my way. Marry me today and every day. Marry me. If I ever get the nerve to say hello.
I can't believe it has been 10 years since you asked for that brace-faced girl's number from wrestling practice. Who would have thought we would be just hours away from saying I do? Throughout the years, I have watched this punk kid grow up into the man of my dreams. Your patience for me never ceases to amaze me. From the time I forgot to pull your Chrysler 300 in park and it went rolling down the hill into the fence. You never screamed or yelled, even as you were trying to stop the two-ton car from rolling further. You comforted me and assured me everything was going to be okay. There was also that time I accidentally got your key stuck where it was revving your engine, even after you warned me not to turn it too far. You come to my rescue, or maybe your truck's rescue, and assured me once again it was going to be okay. I know whatever the world throws at us, it's always going to be okay with you by my side. As your wife, I promise to work on being as patient as you are. Although it may take some time, I promise to always listen when you talk about trucks and engines, even when I have no clue what you're saying. I promise to love you every day and never give up when times get rough, as you are my forever. Always and forever, Amanda. When your legs don't work like they used
to before. To my love, Amanda, it is almost hard to believe that our day is finally here. After all these years, all the good times and bad, from a boy, shy blonde girl in the wrestling room to the beautiful woman that I will soon make my wife. Looking over it all, I know that the Lord has timely blessed me with the greatest gift of all, a truly amazing, wonderful woman. From being a young, dumb kid to what I would consider a semi-successful man, you have always been there for me. Through all my dumb mistakes and all my accomplishments, you have stood by my side. That is where I see your heart the most when I look back. And that is something that makes me fall for you more and more every day I spend with you. Your big heart and how you care so deeply for others and how you always put others before yourself. You are truly the most beautiful person I have ever met inside and out. I know there is no way I can pay you back for all the things that you have done for me, but I am going to do my best by being there for you and your big heart for the rest of our lives. I cannot imagine my life without you. I cannot imagine happiness without your face. I vow to always love you unconditionally and to always be there for you. I vow to always be patient and understanding. I vow to always be always be the spiritual leader and Christ follower of our household. I vow to love you until the end of time, as husband and wife and best friends for life. I love you, sweetheart, always and forever. Memory fades.
And the crowds don't remember my name. When my hands don't play the strings the same way. I know you will still love me the same. Cause honey, your soul could never grow. Baby, your smile's forever in my mind and memory. I'm thinking about how people fall in love in mysterious ways. And maybe it's all part of a plan. Well, I'll just keep on making the
together to witness the marriage of Thomas Lawson and Amanda Hargesinger. And at the same time, we will see a dream come true. It's been told, and it comes from a good source, that Thomas has said several times that he would like to marry Amanda, and his dream is going to come true today. Who gives Amanda to be married to Thomas?
Her mother.
Okay. You may be seated, please. Thomas and Amanda, your family and friends are here this evening to share with you in one of the most important dates in your life. The day you make a commitment to each other and therefore tell the world that you belong to one another. Marriage is an honorable estate blessed by God and by our Lord Jesus Christ. As we think about marriage, it was the first institution that God arranged. God had just created the world. He was looking at it and he said, "It is good." And then he created man. And then he looked and said, "It's not good for man to be alone." So he said, "I will make a suitable helpmate for her." So God caused a deep sleep to fall on Adam, and he took a rib from his side and made woman from that rib. There's one thing that we do know, that God made Eve for Adam. And Thomas, I believe that God made Amanda for you. And Amanda, I believe that God made Thomas for you. Let's have a short prayer. Our Father in heaven, we are so thankful for this day of joy, for this beautiful day that we have. And Father, we ask your blessings upon Thomas and Amanda as they make their lives together. And Father, we ask that you would bless this ceremony. We pray in the name of Jesus. Amen. Amen. A lasting marriage is based on the foundation of genuine love. Marriage is not just infatuation. Marriage is a sacrificial offering to one another. Paul had something to say about the husband and wife relationship. He told the husband to love your wife just as Christ loved the church and gave himself up for her. I believe you both will find true love in giving yourselves up for one another. Thinking about what is best for the other and then doing it. Paul speaks of such love in 1 Corinthians, the 13th chapter, starting in verse 1. "Now I will show you a more excellent way. If I speak in the tongues of men and of angels, but have not love, I am only a resounding gong and a clanging cymbal. If I have the gift of prophecy and can fathom all mysteries and all knowledge, and if I have a faith that can remove mountains but have not love, I am nothing. If I give all I possess to the poor and surrender my body to the flames but have not love, I gain nothing." And this part of these verses is what I really like. Love is patient. Love is kind. It does not envy. It does not boast. It is not proud. It is not rude. It is not self-seeking. It is not easily angered. It keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices in truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, always perseveres. And I kind of like the word always in there. You probably realize that marriage sometimes is not easy. Sometimes it doesn't seem fair. It's not always fun. But let me assure you that it's the most sacred, the most enjoyable thing that you will ever do in your life. And here's a point or two that I'll pass on, because I've been married a few years. To make your marriage more enjoyable, your personal commitment to the promises you make today will help do that. Your commitment to love one another, and then also your relationship with God, who wants to help you make your marriage work. Solomon wrote in these words in Ecclesiastes 4, verse 9. Two are better than one because they have a good return for their work. If one falls down, his friend can help him up. But pity the man who falls and has no one to help him up. Also, if two lie down together, they will keep warm. But how can one keep warm alone? Though one may be overpowered, two can defend themselves. A cord of three strands is not quickly broken. And that cord of three strands is God, Thomas, and Amanda. Remember that God took a rib from Adam to make Eve. She was not taken from his head so that he could rule over her. It was not taken from his foot so he could walk over her, but he was taken from his side near his heart, a cord of, so that you can walk hand in hand, side by side together through life. Since it's your desire to become husband and wife, will you face each other and hold your hands? You're already doing that. I want to remind you that marriage is about God joining two people together. Jesus said in Matthew 19, verse 4, haven't you read that at the beginning the Creator made them male and female and said, for this reason a man will leave his father and mother and be united to his wife, and the two will become one flesh. So they are no longer two, but one. Therefore, what God has joined together, let man not separate. This joining together in marriage involves the will of God. And as you make your vows, you're entering into a divine relationship. So I'm going to ask you a question, and the answer is yes, or I will, okay? Thomas, do you take Amanda to be your wife, to have and to hold from this day forward? For better or worse, for richer or poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish until death do you part, according to God's will, and hereto give your promise.
I do.
Amanda, it's the same answer. Do you take Thomas to be your husband, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better or worse, for richer or poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish until death do you part, according to God's will, and hereto give your promise?
Yes, I do.
Okay. I suppose there's some rings to be exchanged?
Yes.
There is.
Thomas, Solomon wrote in the Song of Songs these words, place me like a seal over your heart, like a seal on your arm, for love is as strong as death, its jealousy unyielding as the grave. These rings are a seal to you. They are made of precious metal, just like your love is precious. They are a circle, an unending circle, just as your love is without end. And they are a visible sign that the whole world will know that you belong to each other, that you love each other. Thomas, you would place this ring on Amanda's finger and repeat after me. This ring I give thee.
This ring I give thee.
In token and pledge.
In token and pledge.
Of my constant faith.
Of my constant faith.
And abiding love.
And my abiding love.
And Amanda. And I could say the same thing about this ring that you're giving to Thomas. It's precious. Your love is precious. It's a circle. It's an unending circle. Just like your love is unending. And again, this ring is a visible sign that this he belongs to you. Tom, or Amanda, you may place your ring on Thomas's finger and then repeat after me. This ring I give thee.
This ring I give thee.
In token and pledge.
In token and pledge.
Of my constant faith.
Of my constant faith.
And abiding love.
And abiding love.
Okay. Let's have another prayer. Our Father in heaven, we are so thankful for these two that have come tonight to join hands in matrimony, confessing to each one of us here that they love each other, that their love is unending, and they're there to please, to help one another. This be with us as we continue this service. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Thomas and Amanda have chosen to celebrate this union as is symbolized through chemical reactions. In Mark chapter 10, Jesus speaks of marriage and says, "For this reason, a man will leave his father and mother, be joined to his wife, and the two will become one flesh. So then, they are no longer two, but one flesh. Therefore, what God has joined together, let no man separate." Just as two chemicals bond together and result in an entirely new compound, marriage is two people coming together and committing to one another. Chemistry is all about the right mix of chemicals. Some mix have no reaction, some react violently, but the right mix can bond them together and create incredible things. Thomas and Amanda have created the right mix and have chosen to commit their lives to each other to form one bond. Behind me on this table, there's two small vessels which represent Thomas and Amanda as individuals. Their individual families, beliefs, and independent ways. The larger vessel represents the joining of Thomas and Amanda as man and wife. When these two chemicals mix together, they form a new chemical. Their individual properties are gone, and this reaction can never be separated again. Just as these chemicals are bonded together forever, Thomas and Amanda are merging their lives as man and wife. They are creating an inseparable bond as together they prepare to embark on their new journey.
Pour it slow.
We have to go slow.
Okay. Ready?
Slow.
I don't know, nothing.
Go. Slow.
Bug in mind.
Slow.
Oh no. It was going slow. It was going slow. It was going slow.
See? Your love is overflowing.
I promise we practiced a lot.
For as much as Thomas and Amanda have consented together in holy wedlock and have witnessed the same before God in this company and have given each a ring as a symbol of their love, I, a retired elder pastor, and by the authority invested in me by the state of Texas, pronounce you husband and wife.
Is it my cue? Can I do it?
You can kiss your wife.
Yeah.
You can do it. In my honor, Ryan, to be the first to present to you Mr. and Mrs. Thomas Lawson.
Now we walk.
Yeah, I think so. Ready, cool off.
Oh. Yeah! Yeah!
Kiss me. It's the part I like, all the kissing part. That's what I'm talking about.
again. Drive is slow.
I'm Jackie Moore. I met Thomas whenever we started working at Swift together about 6-7 years ago. We started working together. We got a really good bond together. Became friends really quick, really fast. You know, I knew Amanda before I ever met Amanda. Thomas always talked about Amanda. We used to hang stomachs together. Yeah, it sounds nasty, but that's what we did. But really, Thomas always talked about Amanda, never had anything bad to say about Amanda. I may be lying a little bit. Just let me talk.
You're doing great, bro. You're doing great.
No, but really, when I finally met Amanda, you know, she welcomed me as a friend of Thomas. She didn't welcome a lot of friends of Thomas. So for her to welcome me, you know, it meant a lot. It really did. You know, we grew together. They are a relationship that you can actually look at and idolize. A lot of people don't have a relationship like that nowadays. You know, when I look at them, I'm like, man, that's the marriage I want to have. That is the perfect relationship. I don't care what anybody says. Even though Thomas may be a little bitch when it comes to Amanda, but... Granted, little bitch or not, he's going home with the girl tonight and I'm not. I don't know that yet. But I respect you guys. I look up to you guys. You are somebody that I can look forward to. You know, you've helped me and my future with God, as well as, you know, just to look up to somebody that said, like, you know, if I look for a relationship, that's the type of relationship I'm going to look forward to. I mean, I really do idolize you guys. I mean, I look up to you so much. Love both of you so much. Pumpkin. Yeah, you know I'm talking to Pumpkin.
Me, right?
You know, you've cooked me many dinners. And, you know, you're not the best cook, but you do all right.
Josh, where are you? Help me.
Thomas, you eat everything she cooks. But
I eat everything.
But no, really, man, I love you guys. Man, I'm really happy for you. Whenever I seen y'all both up there taking your vows and everything, man, I seen the love. I mean, it was just something unbelievable. I mean, it touched my heart. I'm sure it touched everybody else's heart to see you both up there. And, yeah, I'll bring the mic up here if that's what you want, Anna. But, can you hear me? Mic check, 1, 2, 2. Okay. But not really. I mean, to see both of you up there, man, it's just something to look forward to, you know. Eventually, if I find that one, that's what I want. I want to see the love that I seen in both of your eyes today, tonight, whenever y'all gave each other the rings and said the stupid quotes that y'all said. And but not really, man. I love both of you guys. I hope y'all have a strong and healthy and lovable relationship.
Yeah! Yeah! Yeah!
Cheers.
Please, I had something written down. I forgot about this. So, rewind. Let me get this. I'm not nervous. I just have to read. And I don't know how to read, okay? Shit. Okay. Okay, here it goes. Okay, one thing I know about Thomas, man, is he's always been a loyal friend, and that he loves you, Amanda, more than any being in this life. You truly found a man that would die 1,000 times for you. My advice to both of you, never go to bed angry. Try to fall in love with each other every day and always end goodbyes with I love you. Thomas, my advice to you, keep your mouth shut unless you're agreeing with her. Practice always being wrong and plan. Practice always being wrong and your plans are never a big deal. I'm honored being the best man of your wedding and I wish both of you guys many blessings in your future. I love both of you.
Thanks,
Jess. Yeah.
Cheers.
We love you.
Cheers.
Thank you so much.
Come on, Anna.
It's kind of hard to follow. I don't know if I can ramble that well. So good evening, everyone. I would like to welcome you all and say thank you to Amanda and Thomas for allowing us to share their special day. For those of you who don't know who I am, my name is Anna. I'm Amanda's sister. Having Amanda for a sister has been one of the greatest blessings I've ever had. I once read a quote that said, "A sister is a gift to the heart, a friend to the spirit, and a golden thread to the meaning of life." Sorry, I have to switch. That's exactly what Amanda's been to me. I can remember being little and playing Barbies and talking about how I just wish we were older already. Now that we are, I would give almost anything to go back to those days and be able to play make-believe with my little sister. Even though Amanda is younger than me, I've always looked up to her. She has achieved so much greatness already, and yet she continues to grow and improve every single day. I could never ask for a better best friend to have. One day when Amanda was in middle school, she came home and was so excited to tell me about this cute older boy that she met. It just so happened to be a boy that I had a childlike crush on. But his name was Thomas. She would light up so much anytime that she would talk about him. I knew even back then that they were the perfect match. Looking at them both today, as they have gotten to know each other, it has become more apparent to them and everyone else how perfectly suited they are and how well they complement each other with their shared values and beliefs. Amanda, she has been there through thick and thin. She's been my confidant and my advisor, loyal and protective. She has seen me at my best and seen me at my worst, but most of all, she has and will always be my best friend. Thomas, she will be all of these things to you and more. Today, I'm not losing a sister, but I'm gaining a brother. I would like to take this opportunity to welcome you to our family. The adventure begins here. Could I ask you all to raise your glasses as I propose a toast to Amanda and Thomas? May your dreams be shared visions, your Christian walk be side by side, hand in hand, and your love deepen every day of your lives. To Amanda and Thomas.
All right, let's give our best man and maid of honor a hand. Great job.
Everlasting love for me.